What's poppin' YouTube? JD here, back with yet another fire review. And in this video, guys, I got in my hand one of the cleanest dunks to drop this year, and that is the Nike Dunk Low in the Kentucky colorway. So in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down this sneaker. I am gonna be talking about the leather quality as well as sizing and resale predictions. And of course, as always, I will give you guys an on-feet look, so make sure you stick around till the end. Before I begin this video, just wanted to very quickly say thank you to all of you guys who clicked on this video and who have been supporting the channel. I know there is just a lot of things going on in the world right now, and shoes are really not at the top of anyone's priorities, which is totally, totally understandable. So I really appreciate all of you guys who have clicked and watching this video. And of course, I hope you and your family are healthy and safe. So the Nike Dunk Low Kentucky, some websites listed this as the Nike Dunk Low Varsity Royal. It doesn't really matter. Most people are probably gonna refer to these as the Kentuckys. As you guys probably know already, these were basically part of the Nike Be True to Your School pack, which first released all the way back in 1985. They were high tops back then, and we've seen this pack now retro several times over the last 20 years or so. The most recent retro was in the year 2016 when the Kentucky high tops also retroed. So I do have that high top version right here in my hands. This is the 2016 retro. And now I have the low top, so I'm glad to have both of these in the collection. If I were to pick one of these, I would personally pick the high top. I do like how that looks compared to the low top, just aesthetically. But that's just my opinion. I want to hear yours, so let me know down in the comments. Do you guys prefer the low top version of the Kentuckys or the high tops? Let me know. I actually got this pair from Nike Sneakers. And if you watch one of my recent videos, which was the review of the Sakai Waffles, I mentioned in that video that I didn't win anything on Nike Sneakers for almost a year. And then I actually hit on that pair. And now I hit on these ones, the Kentucky's Low. So it's basically back-to-back releases now that I've hit on Nike Sneakers. So shout out to the Nike algorithm, man. You the real MVP. And yeah, thank you for, I don't know why you guys are giving me all these W's recently, but thank you, Nike algorithm. This sneaker released alongside the Nike Dunk Low in the Syracuse colorway, the Orange Blaze, as you, some of you may call it. And I did, of course, do a full review of this sneaker. I will leave a link to it up here. Make sure you watch that. I did mention in that video that this Syracuse pair is actually my favorite sneaker that dropped this year, because I just love this colorway. But of course, I'm not mad at this pair either. This is just a super clean pair. Out of these two, I was definitely wanting to get the Syracuse much more. Once again, I want to hear your opinion too. Let me know down in the comments. Do you guys like the Syracuse version or the Kentucky version? Based on resale prices, both of these are reselling for pretty much the same price in every size. So it looks like people are quite split on which one they want. So let's get into the shoe. Let's talk about the leather quality. The leather quality is quite good, man. Like for a $100 shoe, you are getting some pretty good leather. Both this pair as well as the Syracuse pair had very nice leather. I don't know why. I heard some people say that the leather on the Kentucky pair was better than the Syracuse pair. Guys, that is just rumors. It's fake news. Don't believe any of that. This is pretty much the same leather on both pairs. This is just a very clean colorway, man. Like, people aren't mad when they see white and blue on a Nike sneaker like this. I mean, of course, you can think about the Game Royals that dropped last year, the Jordan 1 Game Royals. Those proved to be a really popular sneaker. Look at resale prices on that one right now. And this is pretty much the same shade of royal blue on this pair. So whether you have an affiliation to the University of Kentucky or not, you can't go wrong with this colorway. This is a very clean colorway. And above all that, it is extremely easy to wear this shoe. You can wear a colorway like this with pretty much any outfit. It goes great with, you know, blue jeans. You can rock this with black pants, even beige pants. Very quickly, if you're enjoying this video so far, make sure you smash that like button. Of course, it helps out the channel tremendously. And subscribe for more. I am dropping reviews every single week for you guys, so make sure you stick around for more. I do have one complaint with this sneaker though, and that is the sock liner. As you guys can see, the sock liner is done in white here. I don't know why they did that. First of all, white sock liners on any shoe, I think, are a terrible idea because they just look really dirty after like a few wears. And I don't particularly understand why they put a white sock liner on this, because if you look at the high top version, the high top version has a blue sock liner, which I think, first of all, it just looks better on the shoe. And of course, it's better to have a blue sock liner because it just won't get that dirty. Also, the Syracuse orange pair, you can see the sock liner was not done in white, it was done in orange. So it's kind of weird to me that they decided to do a white sock liner on this pair. They should have done it in the royal blue, in my opinion. But yeah, that's pretty much the only complaint I have with this sneaker. These sneakers also come with an extra pair of white laces, and I'm gonna put them on for you right now. So as you guys can see, the white laces definitely change the look of the shoe, make it a bit more cleaner in my opinion. And I personally like the way the white laces look better than the blue laces. But of course, let me know down in the comments, which ones do you guys prefer, the white laces or the blue laces? You really can't go wrong with either pair in my opinion. The white one to me just slightly cleaner, so I would personally go with the white. For sizing purposes, the Dunk Lows for me fit true to size. So whatever your size is in Jordan 1s or in Air Max 1s, Air Max 97s, whatever your size is in those pairs, you will be the same size in the Dunk Low, so just go true to size. Of course, some of you guys cop this sneaker strictly for resale, so let me talk about that really quickly. I'll be honest with you guys, it's super, super difficult right now to predict resale prices on pretty much any sneaker, because as you guys know, the economy has pretty much gone into a recession. We know what's going on with this illness out there that everyone's worried about. Pretty much shops have closed across the world. Nike has shut down its stores in pretty much every country except China. I mean, so many companies I know, I actually even know people who've already lost their jobs. So we're going into a recession, unfortunately. So I actually do think that sneaker prices, just overall, the entire sneaker market is kind of on its way down. I think prices are gonna come down even more maybe in the next few weeks. But this sneaker, I think that maybe the bottom price for this sneaker would probably be hit around like that late April, maybe May mark, because then going into summer, I think the prices on these will definitely creep back up. So I wouldn't wait too long. And even if you wait, I don't think the prices are gonna drop that much. They're probably just gonna drop like by maybe like $10 or so. So if you don't wanna wait and you don't wanna take the risk, I would personally just go ahead and cop them right now because the prices are already pretty damn low for most sizes. If you're trying to sell, I would personally hold on to these until at least the summertime, because a shoe like this, it's definitely, by the end of the year, a lot of people are gonna be sad that they missed out on this pair. And I do think that towards the summer slash end of the year, prices are definitely gonna go up, not just on this pair, but also on the Syracuse colorway. So I would just wait on it. Unless you really need the money, then you can sell right now, but personally, I would wait on it. If you're not already following me on Instagram, make sure you follow me. The handle is right here. It is at JDKick6. That is the easiest place to contact me. I respond to pretty much every single message I get on there, so make sure you follow me on IG. And the on-feed portion of the video, as always, coming up right now. Thank you so much for watching the video, guys. Until next time, peace.